How I went from this to this in 3 months. Continue watching to find out. Hi guys and welcome to the channel. My name is Nicolas Franz-Koltren and today we're going to be looking at how I made this transformation that you saw earlier in 3 months' time. Before we begin, a very quick word about myself. I'm a pharmacist, been a pharmacist for 10 years now, with a big passion for fitness and in particular doing fitness photo shoots like the one you saw earlier. What I particularly enjoy and research the most about is the process of fat loss and how we can get from point A, as you saw in the picture before, to the point B, being a very lean physique, ready and appropriate for a photo shoot. I've broken this formula down to very simple steps for you to be able to follow. In order of importance, it goes like this. Nutrition, training, rest. I'm gonna break down each of these, including two little bonus things towards the end. Step number one, and the most important of all, the holy grail, so to speak, of every fitness transformation, and that's nutrition. The main thing we need to figure out first, before even stepping foot in the gym, is our calorie needs. These vary drastically from people to people. There are many factors that contribute to that, which is metabolism, thyroid function, and all of that. Calories is king. Okay? Calories is king. First, you need to roughly estimate how many calories you consume in a day. This is called total daily energy expenditure, abbreviated to TDEE. There are many calculators online. Now, there's a whole science behind how many calories you subtract, and this is why coaches essentially really, really help people who are needed. And if you can afford a coach, I would most definitely recommend one, because I had one myself for that transformation, even though I've helped so many people throughout the years and I know the process. If you don't have a coach whatsoever, you have to figure out yourself. And by subtracting between 300 to 500 calories from that TDEE number is a very safe way to start. Something to mention here is that the first 2 weeks on this program, after you stick to your calories every single day and weigh yourself every single day, by the way, this is crucial for us to have a weighing log. After you subtract those first calories, by the end of week two, we'll be able to compare the average weigh-ins of the first week to the second week. After we compare that, then the whole process becomes very easy. You go on autopilot, because simply enough, if you didn't lose enough, it means you have to decrease your calories more or up the activity, or do both at the same time. I'm always a fan of increasing the activity because you can only decrease calories so much. Now, how many calories do you drop and how much weight you need to be losing on a weekly basis? Again, this is where the eye of an experienced coach can really make a difference. From my experience throughout the years, anything between 0.4 to 0.8, maximum 1%, 1% is really pushing it, per total kilos or pounds of body weight, that is, that's a healthy and safe amount to lose. Something worth bearing in mind is this thing called metabolic adaptation. Unfortunately, you will face that. The body gets used to the low amount of calories and it fights you back. It's not linear, the process of fat loss, it's more like spikes. This is why I recommend starting with a smaller amount of deficit possible, somewhere between the 300 calories below the TDEE, because you can only drop the calories so much. For an average male, anything below 2000 and most definitely below 1700 to 1800 is way too low and most definitely not recommended to continue for prolonged amounts of time. Yes, you will lose the fat, but there will be some significant muscle mass loss with that. And one of the main side effects of that as well is a significant drop in your testosterone levels. Now, after you figure out your TDEE and your calories, the next thing that's very important and crucial in this fitness journey is to adjust your macronutrients. What I mean by that is mostly the protein, really. Assuming your protein is on point, it doesn't really matter what you do with the carbohydrates or fats. So how do you figure out how much protein you need? I would suggest between 2 to 2.3 grams per kilo of body weight. It might be too much for some, it might be too low for others, that's the sweet spot to ensure that we're not losing too much muscle, we're minimizing muscle loss. And if you're a beginner, you might also add some muscle. I mean, recomposition has been going on, it is a real thing, and multiple studies have shown that. Now, what do we do with carbohydrates and fats? Honestly, guys, it doesn't really matter. Assuming your calories and the protein is on point, it doesn't matter what you do. You can eat according to your needs or any special condition. I would just suggest just distribute the calories equally between carbs and fats after you figure out your protein intake. Now, before we wrap nutrition up, I really have to raise a point on food choices. Do you have to eat clean or can you eat McDonald's every day? If you do eat McDonald's every day, I feel sorry for you, but the hard truth is, if you add the calories down and you make sure you hit your protein from McDonald's, you will have the exact same results. Maybe not so much on the inside, but on the looks, most definitely yes. So, in all seriousness, I definitely recommend keeping it 80% clean at least. The old trusted broccoli, carrots, all kinds of vegetables and fruits. At the end of the day, we want to create a better human both on the outside and the inside. By all means, if your calories allow it, you can have your treats every here and then, ice cream, chocolate, whatever that may be, whatever is doing it for you. And this wraps up the nutrition. Don't make it hard, because it's not. Now on to the next step, workouts. How often and what sort of training do we do? Multiple studies have shown that you do need resistance training in order to maximize fat loss. The optimal for the average person, I would suggest 4 times per week. You wanna do more? Be my guest. I personally don't enjoy those sessions that much because they're really hard. Each one is individual and you need to adjust your training according to your needs. Loads of research has shown that the most efficient way to train is if you hit a muscle group twice per week, as opposed to the bro splits, that's arm day for example, you just annihilate arms. So in order to hit them twice per week, I would recommend doing a split like upper, lower, or push-pull legs, which is a very common one. You can have a look online, you'll find multiple examples of it. But the good thing with an upper, lower is that 4 times a week is all it takes. So you work your upper body one day, the next legs, and you repeat twice with different exercises, obviously. Number of sets. Now, that's also an important one. I keep saying this about the research, but hey, it's what's working, right? We have to follow the research. 8 to 10 reps for most muscle groups is a sweet spot, I would say. So let's say, for example, 4 to 5 sets on one day and you repeat 4 to 5 sets on the day after. You can go higher if you want, but I wouldn't recommend it, especially if you're a natural. And for legs, you can safely go a little bit higher. You can go on 12 or 15 sets if you really have to, but I don't really think there's much need to go down that way. The benefit of working out 4 times a week in an upper, lower kind of split is that you can work every other day. I personally find that amazing, having a day off from the gym every other day. And that ensures that the next time you're going in the gym, you've had a full day of rest, assuming you did that and not just went out and ran a marathon. And you will feel very energized and hit the muscles as hard as they deserve to be hit, so to speak. Now, let's go to the reps. It has been proven throughout the years that anything from 6 to 12 or even 15 reps will do just fine and it's optimal. Now, do you have to reach failure on every single set? Most definitely not. Having said that, it takes an experienced lifter to really know what failure is, because diminishing returns are really, really hard if you don't reach failure and stop, let's say, 4 reps before failure. You're not really doing much there and you won't see many results. So the sweet spot is 1 to 2 reps max before failure, which will ensure you can continue pushing throughout the workout and won't stress your nervous system so much. I would recommend taking 1 muscle group to failure once or twice per week in 1 set, that is. This wraps up the workout and now it's a perfect time for me to show you a sample workout video.
Okay guys, here's a sample workout I did back in July when I was in Greece with my buddy Alex. So we start with pre-exhausting the chest, so to speak. With this variation of the push-up, we're going quite deep and we want to aim near failure. After this, as you can see, we will move on to dips, which is the first real exercise, so to speak, for the chest. And for this one, we'll be doing three sets of anywhere to from 8 to 15, really, depending on the variation of the dip and your strength levels. Straight to back after that, you can see Alex killing the pull-ups here, nice and clean all the way down. Controlled negatives, which is very important. Again, three sets of the same rep range. This one, pike push-ups, very nice exercise for the shoulders. I definitely recommend doing this, and there's many variations you can scale this exercise, so by all means have a look on the internet. Now, next one, I don't know the name of this one frankly, but it's a really nice one. It's the upper part of the muscle up basically, and it's an all-rounder. It targets the chest, the triceps, as you can see. So yeah, definitely recommend incorporating this one in your program. You can see Alex here doing it. Alex is toasted, by the way. He hit triceps the day before. So yeah, he wasn't really happy when I told him we would be doing this. But moving on, biceps. Again, you have to improvise. There were no gyms at the time. They were closed. Controlled negatives again. As you can see, nice and clean reps. Moving on here now, this one is a favorite of mine for the triceps, but I have to warn you here, you can really hurt your elbows. So yeah, I recommend either strapping up or not doing it at all. Ending off here, one for the calves. I love working out calves a lot, to be fair. Resistance is not optimal here because I'm used to heavy loads, but you have to improvise with what you have. So as you can see, I'm going down quite slow. And Alex here demonstrating some knee ups, perfect one for the abs. And that was a sample workout.
And now the last, but by no means least point of the equation is that of rest. If your rest is not on point, your results will significantly diminish. Testosterone falls, your whole clarity is gone throughout the day, workouts are a struggle, and add the calorie deficit on top of all that, and it's guaranteed disaster. Now, how many hours of sleep you need per day? The absolute minimum would be 6, but I want to stress that this is suboptimal. Ideally, you want to aim for 7 or 8, okay? So that's simple there. Make sure you get your sleep right. And this is everything. That's the equation for you. That's every single step you need to follow. And if you follow those three and make sure they're on point every single day, you will have guaranteed results. Now, as I promised you in the beginning of the video, I want to raise the point of two bonus things that will really make this journey easier for you. The first one being cardio and the second one being alcohol. Cardio-wise, do you need it? I would definitely recommend to be doing some form of cardio on a very regular basis. And the most sustainable form of cardio is that of low intensity cardio, which can be done by walking on a treadmill that has an incline set, or any other activity that will keep your heart rate in the zones, in the fat burning zone. So you can figure out your fat burning zone. There's multiple internet calculators out there. As long as you're close on that ballpark of heart rate, then you know that's low intensity cardio and it can be maintained for prolonged amount of times. Now, the other form of cardio is that of high intensity training cardio. It's called HIIT, shortened high intensity interval training, which essentially you set a timer and you do vigorous exercises that raise your heart rate to the max. I'm a big fan of this form of training. A point I want to raise in regards to any form of high intensity interval training is I would never recommend to do it more than twice or absolute max 3 times per week, ideally twice, because it's really taxing on the nervous system and it will affect your recovery, and therefore your weight sessions will suffer, and that's the last thing we want. It's very important for you to be sticking to whatever cardio you choose to. Let's say you're on the 4 times per week split that I mentioned earlier, you can most definitely be doing 20 minutes of cardio. Start with 20 minutes, then you have a very strong tool for you to use and adjust accordingly. If your weight didn't go down as much as you wanted to, Start adding 10 minutes on all your cardio sessions after your workout, and consider dropping 100 calories. The less variables in the equation, the easier it is for you to track it. Now, the last one, the last point, I've been waiting for this one. Alcohol. Oh yes. Now, I do love a party, don't get me wrong. I'm sure you can tell. Okay, so what's the deal with alcohol? If we're talking a glass of wine or whiskey or even a can of beer a day, that's really not an issue. Although, multiple studies again have shown that by the time you reach the drunken state, you have to wave goodbye to your fat loss for that day and potentially for a couple days after. There's complicated stuff going on inside the cells that alcohol does that are way beyond the scope of this video. Basically, they affect the way the mitochondria work. So, moderate drinking, most definitely yes, but getting absolutely hammered, I have to be honest with you, it will really set you back. There has been sessions, proper sessions, that set me back for a good week and a half. The scale just wouldn't go down, I would feel all puffed up. Assuming you calculate the alcohol calories and have them from alcohol, then that's fine. But definitely don't do the binge eating after the sesh. And this is it. This is everything you need for you to go out there and get shredded. Now, something I want to stress again is the importance of having a coach. I had a coach myself in that transformation, even though I didn't need one from the knowledge point of view. But having a coach, if you can afford it, ensures that you just have to follow some guidelines and the whole thing becomes on autopilot, so to speak, and that's everything. When you're calorie restricted, your clarity is not that much on point, and the last thing you want to do is stressing about all those variables. Or I have this happen again in the past. Someone will tell you, oh, you look really skinny, and that will really mess with your head. Then you will just adjusting calories out of random. You'll be like, oh, well, I need to raise them because someone told me I look skinny. So yeah, no, those things should never be happening. And whatever the goal, the predefined goal is from the beginning, you have to stick to it without deviating at all. Another very important thing a coach can help you with is his objective eye. What do I mean by that? You might have some muscle groups that are really, really lagging, or some others that are not quite there in proportion with the rest of your body. Remember, what we want to do here is essentially create that aesthetic V-taper physique, the one we see in the magazines, the one that's sought after. And the way to achieve that differs from person to person. I have many clients who really lack muscle groups like the calves or forearms, so we make sure we incorporate those in the program in higher reps, more sets, and that's the only way to target those things. So a coach can most definitely help you there, and that's what we do here at Cult Labs. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you gained a thing or two out of this. That's the point of all these videos. I want to share the information with you just so everyone can experience the benefits of fitness. There will be way more videos in which I'll be going deep into the science behind fat loss, what supplements you need to be taking, what form of exercises. So if that's of interest to you, most definitely subscribe, as well as staying up to date with cultlabs.com. My latest post there actually is about liposomal supplements, and if you don't know what they are, then you should most definitely give it a read. That's enough of me rambling. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next video.